Are you your friend?
Sure. Let's hear him then.
Wake up.
I'm awake.
Gaspard, stand back. I'm opening the door.
Gaspard, you seem a bit muddled.
Muddled. A bit drowsy, that's all.
What of the others?
Found one near a monster's den. He was already dead, sadly. Saw another fall from a cliff. Broke his neck.
Shit. Ravenick told me to have an eye on the snot. 'Twas his nephew. Thanks for helping. And, sorry I didn't trust you.
Oh, everything's gone wrong. What'll we do now?
Got a boat. You can leave with me. But I need to find someone first.
An ashen-haired lass?
Yes.
Oh, dreadful sorry.
What do you mean?
She's cold. Spirits left her.
Must have passed shortly before we found her.
Let's wait by the boat.
Guess not all of Vesemir's teachings have receded into oblivion.
A Witcher can forget to eat, to drink, to breathe even. But a Witcher never, ever forgets to care for his blade.
Yeah, I used to repeat that incessantly. Never tired of doing it either.
What creature was it?
Creature?
One that gave you the scar over your left eye. It's new. I don't remember it.
Souvenir from the Cockatrice of Spala. Another addition to the collection. Nothing special. Yours has healed beautifully, though.
Avalok. He prepared some special ointments for me. But that was before the curse gripped him. Wonder where he is now.
We lifted the curse. He's at Kaer Morhen, waiting for you.
Are you serious? You must be. You'd not jest about something like that. A nice thing to wake up to.
You trust him?
Avalok? He's not let me down to date. Not once.
Why exactly is Avalok helping you? Sages have never been fond of humans.
He doesn't do it for me. It's about my power. As if it could ever be about anything else. Avalok tried to teach me how to control my ability. He was also making sure I didn't fall into Eridan's hands.
What's Eridan after? What's he want from you?
What everyone wants. Control of my powers. His homeworld faces annihilation. Eridan's decided to invade ours. Brilliant, wouldn't you say? Can't achieve much on his own, so he needs to bring an army. Except his navigators can't possibly move him and thousands of NL between planes. Their abilities won't allow it.
Whereas yours will.
Exactly. And if I die in the process, well, that's a necessary sacrifice.
How do you ever start traveling with Avalok?
As soon as I'd left you and Yen on the Isle of Avalon, I found myself pursued. Eridan and his Red Riders were on my heels. I fled through many worlds, many times. They came very close to catching me once. It was then that Avalok appeared, out of nowhere. He found a portal and took us to a world where Eridan couldn't find us for, oh, perhaps half a year.
The world where Eridan couldn't find you, what was it like?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Try me.
People there had metal in their heads, waged war from a distance, using things similar to megascopes. And there were no horses. Everyone had their own flying ship instead.
Ciri, stop fooling around.
Told you wouldn't believe me. We should have stayed there.
So why'd you return?
I thought the Hunt had lost my scent for good. I thought I was safe. Besides, I wanted to find you. You and Yennefer.
You were looking for us. We were looking for you. Times I thought you were just a step away. Other times, felt like I was going around in circles.
I'm not surprised. There were times I fled pell-mell head first and forward.
So tell me how it happened, step by step.
Eridan located us mere moments after we landed on Ardskellig. Soon after, he and his riders surrounded us. I thought it was over, the end. Turned out Eridan had other plans. He produced the phylactery, uncorked it. A fog enveloped us, and Avalok began gasping for air.
That's how Eridan cursed Avalok, triggered his transformation into Uma?
Yes. He didn't wish to kill him. Humiliation, that's what he was after. But Avalok refused to succumb without a fight. He cast a spell that wrought havoc in the Hunt's ranks.
And in a full half of a forest on Ardskellig.
Yet it also gave us time to flee. Avalok opened a portal. I leapt in. He was supposed to follow right behind me, but something went awry. Impaired by the curse, he failed to reach the portal in time. We had agreed that if anything went wrong and we were separated, we would meet at his hideout in Velen.
But you failed to meet there.
Yes, we failed to. Once through the portal, instead of at Avalok's hideout, I landed right in the middle of Crookback Bog. I barely escaped the crones. And then there was the Baron. You know, he took me hunting. I killed a wild boar with my sword.
I heard.
A coincidence, really. I had no desire to hunt that day, but it felt wrong to refuse. I'd taken nothing remotely resembling a hunting weapon. I simply hadn't intended to hunt. I was wandering through the forest, breathing deep the air. And then I heard a strange sound. Unsettling.
Boar attacked you?
Mm-hmm. Big as a bison, and lumbering straight at me. And all I had was my sword. Had to manage.
Did just fine, judging by how the Baron's men remember it.
Simple soldiers, the whole lot. But we got along splendidly. A shame I had to leave. Flee. But I didn't want to bring the Wild Hunt down on them. Apart from which, I knew by then the curse was progressing. So instead of looking for Avalach, I decided to find you and Yen.
So how do you even meet a man like Horson Jr.?
You and Yennefer were nowhere to be found, and I needed someone who could fix the phylactery. No ordinary craftsman would do. I needed a mage, one with extraordinary powers. Dandelion took it upon himself to help me. It was as if his honor depended on it. He arranged a meeting with a mage, but it proved a trap set by the temple guard.
Failed to mention that.
Probably didn't want to worry you. Later, we learned the guard did that sort of thing regularly, in the hope of nabbing anyone who collaborated with mages. We needed to find another way. That was clear. Then Dandelion said he knew a man who owned a piece of Novigrad, as he put it, could do more than others. He was certain to know someone who could fix the phylactery.
Horson Jr.
Mm-hmm. I suspected it might not be the best idea, but I was desperate. I had no choice.
You suspected right. Horson was not the ideal partner in crime.
Damned simpleton got it in his head that we'd cheated him and kidnapped Dudu.
Who you promptly freed only to have to flee to Temple Isle. Great idea.
We hadn't planned it. Had no time to consider. We'd just bolted. I didn't even realize the guardsmen were driving me into a trap. Suddenly there I was, and I knew I had to disappear. At once.
And that's when you landed back in Skellige.
The shore of Hindisfjall. The first pleasant place that came to mind. Hjalmar and I used to swim there.
Wait, so you actually wound up there by accident? I thought you and Avalok had arranged something.
No, he simply sensed me use my power. Just as Eredin can sense where I am, where I travel. In fact, Eredin arrived soon after I did. His riders in tow. Once again, things happened quickly. Lofoten, the Hunt's attack, my flight. And then, dreams. Just dreams.
What did you dream? I've had nothing but nightmares lately. Pretty horrible.
Likewise, for the most part. In one, a monster grown from a stillborn child chased you. Ugh, that was horrible. Had a few nice dreams. For example, in one we sat around a fire, drinking good wine, and all around people danced and laughed.
I like that one a lot better.
Me too. But these dreams, and the others, ended in some tower. No matter what I'd dream, in the end, I would enter a tower.
Recognize it? Know where it might be?
Not sure. I don't think so, but there was something familiar about it. And something terrifying. The tower was stark and dead. But at the same time, I felt I had to enter it.
Did you?
No. Dreams all ended with me searching for the entrance. And the last time, instead of the tower, I saw your grizzled face. If not for the scar over your eye, I'd have thought I was still dreaming.
I was afraid you were dead. Found some dwarves here. Said they'd try to wake you, but you were cold as ice, and you weren't breathing.
And yet you came in.
Who listens to dwarves these days? Speaking of which, they're probably getting antsy. We should go. Got a boat on the beach. Once we land, we'll head for Kaer Morhen, on horseback.
Right. Conventional means of travel. They're just better.
Though a portal would be quicker.
And draw Eredin to us immediately. Rather not risk it. Besides, I hate portals. Damn! Listen, we gotta think of a way to...
Welcome back, child.
Siri! My, you've grown beautiful.
No point standing around. Come on, time to greet the others.
You've not changed a bit. Any of you. Just like I remembered.
What?
Little sis.
All here. Everyone you asked for help. Avalox resting in the tower, still in pretty bad shape. No reason to do it out here. Come inside.
Damn, it's good to see you again.
Glad to see you, Triss.
Thank Yennefer. She's the one who invited me.
There'll be time to talk later. We should confer now.
Thank you.
Yen, you know the Wildhunt better than anyone else. Tell us about the magic they use.
Their navigators open portals, rifts that we might counter with Dimeridium or our own magic. They also summon the frost that occupies the voids through which they travel.
There's just not enough of us. It'll be a hard fight.
Good to see you. Ah, Geralt. How are things?
Farewell, Ancrate.
Ha! You folk.
Bring all your tools with you?
Thought to myself, a battle approaches. Blades will need honing. Plate will need some hammering. That sort of thing.
Thought right. Thanks, Sultan.
Plan to top that by brewing some more Mahakam and mix. Shite so volatile you need but glance at it to set it off like a flaming fart. Very useful during sieges.
Willing to craft something for me?
Of course. Provided you've a diagram.
Willing to craft...
Of course.
We'll talk later, Zoltan.
I certainly hope this gas will work.
She's one of us, Geralt. No way we'll let him take her. Damn piece of junk. Barely younger than Vesemir.
Esko.
Greetings, Wolf.
Esko.
Need some peace. You gotta prepare.
We'll go higher.
Glad to see you.
Huh. Set out alone, Vess tracked me down. Insisted on coming.
I ought to give you a hiding for not asking my help. But I took it all out in Roach along the way.
Ah. Some old friends.
What's this horse son doing here?
We need him.
You might have forgotten what he did. I haven't.
Gotta save Ciri, whatever the cost. And Letho's faced the hunt before.
I don't question his abilities. I simply don't trust him.
Letho won't betray us.
You're naive. Always have been. Usually I don't give a shit, but this time it could kill Vess and me both. Think this through before it's too late.
We'll stay and help. But we don't want him at our backs.
Big fight ahead of us. How's morale?
Remember our encounter with them at the Hanged Man's Tree. We'll thrash him again this time.
Greetings, Geralt. If I'm to die today, I wish to look smashing for the occasion.
Getting all gussied up for the Wild Hunt?
Women only ever beautify themselves for their own satisfaction.
Glad you're here.
It's good to see you again.
Expected you earlier.
I started off heading in the opposite direction, but then turned around.
What made you change your mind?
There are times when a woman should simply not explain her decision. That goes doubly for sorceresses.
Get everybody together. Time to talk. Thank you for coming. The Wild Hunt will be here soon. They're coming for Ciri. Want to take her? We'll stop them.
How do you even know the Hunt will show?
They always know where I teleport to, and they move from place to place in an instant.
So what's our plan?
There aren't many of us, but I'd trust any of you with my life. Work together and we'll defeat the Hunt. When they attack, Yen'll dome the fortress with a magic shield. Hunt'll be forced to land outside the walls.
If they're dispersed out in the woods, we could hunt down small groups of riders.
Got our first volunteer for the hunting party. I'm the second.
Count me in, too. Always believed attack is the best defense.
The Hunt will try to penetrate into the fortress through navigator portals. I can do nothing against this kind of magic, so you'll need to find and close as many as you can while hunting in the woods.
Lambert will make us dimeridium bombs. Remember the formula?
Of course.
Excellent. Erdan should work on the portals as well. I shall also give you each an amulet. Snap them in half and you'll become invisible, at least while you remain still or move slowly. Move abruptly, engage any foes, clash with them, and they will see you. Apart from that, they will be able to hear you and smell you. If you come across a large unit, do not attack. Signal Triss and she will provide support.
I'll look for your signal. Soon as I see it, I'll rain fire on the forest.
Remember, there's only a few of us. We have to help each other, work together. If anything goes wrong and the Hunt puts us on the defensive, we pull back, make a stand at the gates of the fortress. The inner courtyard is our last line of defense. If we don't stop them there, we're doomed. Ciri's most important in all of this. The Hunt's after her, and we have to defend her at all costs.
What do I do?
Stay inside the keep. If they break through, come inside. We'll all converge to help you.
Out of the question! I can look after myself.
No one doubts that, child. But remember the most important moment when hunting a monster?
Wait for an opportunity. After the council, I'll give you an amulet. If you use it, a ball of fire will land where you're standing, just in case.
What else do we have that we can use?
Since you plan to ambush the Hunt in the woods, I could dig some trapping pits, Blue Stripe style.
Meaning?
Deep as the dark abyss, bottoms bristling with sharpened stakes.
I brought this Mahakaman mix. Flammable as bone-dry saltpeter and plowing sticks to everything. We fill some barrels, stack them in a narrow passage, and fire them up at an opportune moment.
You know we stand on a vast deposit of gas. If need be, I could open cracks in the earth, create explosions. I would need to prepare, though.
There's the laboratory and the workshop.
One thing to remember, we've got limited resources and even less time. We ought to decide what kind of weaponry will be most useful against the Hunt.
Absolutely. We need to assign one type of weaponry each to the lab and workshop.
Anyone have any ideas for the workshop?
Been wanting to fix that breach in the wall, but we'll need the same tools to clear the rubble from the armory.
Rubble?
Haven't you heard? Roof caved in a couple of years back. There's some excellent swords in there. Swords we could use.
Filling in the breach seems just as important. They come through there, the siege will be over awfully quick.
Fixing the breach in the wall's a priority.
Let's not forget the laboratory. I started brewing some potions. Like to finish, if you don't mind.
I could prepare more of those Witcher's traps, but I'd need all the lab equipment.
There aren't many of us, so we'll need to prepare as many traps as possible.
We won't have time to do much else. Everything settled?
Yes, settled. We don't have much time, so let's get to work.
Let's sum up. Yennefer will create a magic barrier to repel the main assault. That should push the opposing force into the woods, where Lambert, Geralt, and Letha will be waiting. They'll use Dimeridium to close the Navigator's portals, stop as many warriors as possible from entering the fortress. Triss will be waiting for their signal, then give the Riders hell. All others will repel any foes who make it inside the fortress walls.
If anything goes wrong, we abandon the outer courtyard, pull back to the keep. Remember, Aridin can't get his hands on Ciri. That's most important. Let's look at the map of the fortress, figure out the details. Can't help feeling we've overlooked something important.
Don't think about it.
Wanted to talk about what we can expect.
Thanks, not interested. You should talk to Ciri, fine mood she's in.
I'm exposing you all to danger, unnecessarily.
You worry too much. Wipe that frown off your face, we'll make it.
Thanks for everything.
I'll saddle the horses. Come once you're ready to head into the woods.
Taking Letha with us.
You know my opinion.
see that?
It's starting. Woods, now.
Gonna have to thank Yen once this is all over. That spell, really something. And the invisibility.
Hounds could sniff you out, so don't get too close. And you'll be visible as soon as you start fighting. Remember that.
He always talked this much.
Only when he's nervous. Good work with these bombs, by the way.
Aim at the portals. Be precise. I'm out of dimeridium.
Yen mentioned casting the Erden at the rifts. Said the sign could seal them.
They're here. Time to say hello.
Slow down. Element of surprise is key. Stay hidden. Give Triss a chance to show them what she can do. Then we'll hit them.
Mean to say Marigold can conjure up more than a cloud of butterflies?
Lots more. Wait and see.
Next time you get the feeling I'm about to piss off Marigold, make sure and knock me upside the head.
Pits. Couldn't have asked for anything more perfect.
Are you kidding? We're lucky we didn't fall in.
Relax. Roach is good at this kind of warfare. Covers won't collapse in raw weight. That's a new story.
Not that I don't trust this invisibility.
Thank you.
problem solved.
Geralt! Come here! Look! They're regrouping!
See the commander? Name's Imlarith. I remember him from back when I rode with the Hunt.
Damn it! Spell's waning. We're becoming visible.
We're gonna try to kill him.
Too risky.
Pansy.
What's with Marigold?
Shit.
You were meant to wait inside!
I cannot hide forever. I must face them.
Back inside now!
No! Geralt gave the signal from the woods and Triss hasn't cast the spell.
Damn it! All right, run to her.
Geralt!
Head back.
Ah!
wing! Wizards almost at the fortress!
Master!
Don't stop! Garagor will shield us!
Wonder if it took him out.
Imlarith?
Large detachment approaching from the woods. We need to close the gate before they get inside.
Esco.
Damn it! He agreed he'd open that gate.
Hasn't done it yet. Means...
he'll be fine. We've got Triss to worry about now.
Come on.
Shaky.
We had to fall back. They tried to get in through the main gate. I'm afraid they could succeed next time.
What's with Eskel? We have to retreat. He's in trouble. I'm going to help him. Remember the stone I gave you.
Them.
Driscoll's opened the gate! We can retreat beyond it! Fall back!
You're not supposed to be out here.
Too late now.
They're coming in through the gaps!
Time iridium bombs. You'll find more in the crates by the walls.
Gunner, hold them back. I must form a circle of vitality.
Gotta close the portals. If we don't, we die.
Thank you.
abandon you. You humans are so impractical.
Ciri, no! I forbid you! You always were an unruly child. I adored that about you. Now fly!
I...
I was too late to help him.
It's not your fault.
I should not have fled here to Kaer Morhen.
Avalok is weak, but alive. Triss is tending to the others.
I nearly killed you. Killed everyone.
We'd all be dead if not for you.
No, Geralt. The hunt would never have come to Kaer Morhen if I wasn't here.
Vesemir's funeral. We should prepare. Himself. No witcher's ever died in his own bed.
You don't know how it is to see someone you love die. Because of you. For you.
We all knew what we were signing up for.
Yes. And you saved me. For how long? A week? A month?
We'll hide you. Cover your tracks.
No. I will flee no more.
Vafail. For those who remain, death should never take precedence over life. Pay your last respects to your friend. Then we must hold counsel.
What's on your mind?
Kaer Morhen. Can't imagine this place without Vesemir. I'll head down the valley soon, then find somewhere else to winter next year.
Come on, it's the only home we've ever had. Stay.
No, Geralt. Place has been dying a while. Last nail in the coffin today. Time we accepted that.
Thank you.
Please. She was my ward, too. And the old should only ever stick around to help the young. You know, this hardly ends your struggle.
I know.
Whatever you aim to do now, remember you'll find souls willing to aid you in Skellige. Myself, Hrach, his children.
Thanks. I'll remember that.
I shall take another look at the wounded. But I'll need to go soon. I'll leave you some medicines.
Go in hell, Thermion.
Till we meet again.
No reason to come back here. It's like Kaer Morhen died today.
There you are. Crying shame about Vesemir. I'm sorry.
Thanks for your help.
I had a debt to pay.
Heading straight back to Skellige?
Duty calls. But listen, Geralt. You've a king for a mate. Where's the man who can claim that? If you or Ciri, or you and Ciri, if yous ever need help, the gates of Kaer Trold stand open.
Thanks. I'll remember that.
Come to see how I'm feeling. Thanks. Not bad.
That's good.
Ah, son. Horrible about Vesemir. I know you were close.
Thanks. We were.
Listen, far be it from me to stick my beard, but it'll no scratch an itch. So don't take this the wrong way. I want to help, whatever you decide, but to my mind, we've got to counterattack. We've got to find the Hunt, Eredin, and charge at them both like a bull at a heifer.
There aren't enough of us. Sure, we repelled the Hunt's assault, but that was a miracle, plain and simple. Won't be so lucky next time.
Forgive me, Geralt, but that's the blathering of a man who clearly can't snap out of it after a tragic loss. Drink it off. Sleep it off, whatever it takes. Just get yourself together and think things through.
I'll do that, Sultan. Thanks for everything you did for me and Ciri.
May I be honest? Had I known what would happen here, I'd never have come anywhere near Kaer Morhen. I'm glad I could help, but I shall leave as soon as Lambert feels better.
You going together?
I've an idea, but I need a witcher to help me see it through. Lambert has agreed to assist me.
Good luck, and thanks again.
We're even now.
Can we talk?
What about?
Holding up all right?
Love questions like that. Am I holding up? What? My dick? This is shit, Geralt, and you know it. I knew the old man couldn't live forever. Even told Eskel that when it came time, I'd get his sword. Fits my hand perfectly, you know? But Vesemir deserved a better death. Whereas he died like a louse. Crushed.
We'll avenge him.
Doesn't look that rosy to me.
Try not to get into any arguments, can you? They've all come here to help.
Are you gonna tell me how to behave now?
No, just asking you nicely.
How's this for a nice answer? Kiss my ass.
See you later.
Yeah, take care.
So,
Tell me.
I can say I've seen it all now.
I still don't believe everything that happened.
Risked your lives for me. How can I repay you?
We'll think of something. Right?
Definitely.
What will you do?
We're bound for Novigrad. To fight the next fight.
If you miss us, look for us at the camp.
That was tough.
We managed.
Thanks for helping.
You're welcome.
What will you do now?
Probably head east, cross the mountains. After that, we'll see.
Farewell. I'll remember your teachings always, and the sacrifice you made.
Zirel can harness immense amounts of the power. Why has no one taught her to control this?
Actually, some did teach her.
Clearly, to no effect.
I'll gladly argue with...
Haven't had a chance to talk. Thanks for your help. And for looking after Ciri.
You will thank me later. Now we must take Zirel from here, hide her. And then gather a greater force.
Anyone, everyone we could count on came here to Kaer Morhen.
Which is why we must seek the help of enemies. Magic is our best defense against the Hunt. We need sorceresses. Archmistresses of magic.
You mean the Lodge?
Many of the Lodge's members are dead. The rest are in hiding.
Philippa Eilhart, Margarita Loantil, and Fringilla Vigo are likely still alive.
And Francesca? And Ida? Think they'd agree?
I think they'll take convincing. Would you rather speak to Kira alone?
That would probably be best.
Don't trust the Lodge one bit, but doesn't seem like we have a choice.
Because we don't. I've made an agreement with the Emperor. In exchange for its help, the Lodge will be granted amnesty and find asylum in Nilfgaard. That will be our bargaining chip. Triss, I wish to leave today to find the sorceresses. Will you help me?
Of course. Even got an idea where you could start.
Damn it! Again you planned without even asking what I think. I've heard enough of this. I won't be taken somewhere like a bundle. I will not sit and twiddle my thumbs. I am sick of waiting, sick of hiding.
You're right. Prove today you can take care of yourself.
Easier to pat someone on the back and hope things will work out than it is to face the truth. Zirel possesses a great power she cannot control. She is a danger to herself, to others. Until she learns to control it, she should remain isolated.
First of all, bollocks. Second, if you're going to speak of courage, at least address me directly, and not through Geralt. I'm gone.
Ciri needs time.
True, but she also needs training. She must learn to control her abilities.
This training really necessary?
You saw what happened. She could be a greater threat than the Hunt.
Fine. We'll stay here a while longer, then join you and Triss in Novigrad. Meet at Dandelion's Inn.
Come on, Yen. The sooner we leave, the better.
See ya.
It's not working, don't you see?
Discouraged after a mere 8 attempts? Sierra.
How many times must I try?
As many as it takes.
But I'm not getting anywhere.
We shall return to this later.
Didn't make it far first time out on the gauntlet either.
Geralt, please, not now. By comparison, the gauntlet was a walk in the park. But that's not the point.
What is?
Avalar says nothing will come of this until I stop thinking about the battle. But at the moment, I find it impossible to fill my head with kittens and vanilla pudding. Tell me, how do you do it?
What?
Always manage to pull yourself together. Focus. No matter what's happening.
There's a certain ancient method. Vesemir taught it to me, and Barman taught it to him.
Will you take me into the mountains and make me drink hemlock?
The Skellige druids have used it for centuries. It always works.
Hey! You'll regret that!
Hey, that's cheating.
Wimp.
We'll see about that.
Come and get me. You were right. That really works. Thanks.
Glad to be of service. So what now?
I'll go see where our dearest sage is.
What? What's happening?
Get up. We must go. I've saddled the horses.
Ciri, it's the crack of dawn. Where do you want to go?
To Velen. Bald Mountain. But a few days till the Witch's Sabbath. And guess who's the guest of honor?
Dunno. Enlighten me.
Imlarith. We'll have no better chance to get him.
Where'd you get this idea? What's gotten into you?
I must avenge Vesemir. The Sabbath. It's the perfect opportunity. Imlarith will be drunk among his cohorts, caught up in the revelry. He'll not expect the blow.
How'd you learn all this? Imlarith? The Sabbath?
Avilach. He told me of those who chase us. Claims knowledge itself can tip the scales. Come. We shall talk on the way.
Lead on.
Ready?
Let's go.
After the Battle of Kaer Morhen, the defenders licked their wounds and mourned their losses, save Ciri, who began to plan a revenge. She woke Geralt one night and urged him to travel with her to Velen, to the top of Bald Mountain, where she knew she'd find Imlarith. She had decided he had to die.
The men at Crow's Perch, they spoke of this place. Ard Serbin, home of the Ladies of the Wood. The peasants feared coming here, and the Baron thought the Ladies of the Wood a terrifying tale for naughty children. Incidentally, I wonder how the Baron is.
Hanged himself after his wife died. Daughter's in Novigrad.
A true shame.
Actually know this area?
Centuries ago, it was a hallowed site for druids. But then the crones arrived, destroyed the Velen Circle, and deformed the sacred oak atop the mountain. An important feast is observed here annually. The Sabbath, they call it. All the local folk attend. I suspect Imlarith attends too, as the crone's guest.
Seem to know it well.
Havelark's a good tutor.
We stand to find Imlarith here? You sure?
Avilach told me of beings who commune with the NL elves. They can be found in every part of our world. In Velen, the crones do this.
Apparently, Imlarith came here at Eridan's behest to order the crones to keep their eyes open and ears pricked in case Avalok were to seek shelter in his Velen hideout.
Took the order literally, judging by all the ears hanging in the woods. Think Imlarith might still be here?
He craves the pleasures of the flesh, wine, sex. The crones indulge him, flatter his ego. I'm certain he'd not let this opportunity pass, and will be on Bull Mountain for the Sabbath.
Let's get this done.
We must reach the peak. We'll find Imlarith there. The peasant folk of Velen call this night the Feast of Gifts. I've no idea why. Avalok claims vanity is Imlarith's greatest weakness.
Loads of footprints.
Vanity?
Proud of peasants came through here.
Strives to impress. The other one, Caranthia, is said to be secretive and pragmatic. Hardly surprising, given he was Avalok's student.
Should I shoot?
The White One once served the ladies.
But he's an outsider!
Let them approach.
But...
they've come for the feast. Wouldn't do to cast them out.
Didn't come to celebrate. We need to get to the top of the mountain.
The gate is shut. You'll not pass. But we've fires down that way, with food and drink aplenty. Sit down beside one, and perhaps this year the ladies will descend. Give us the privilege of seeing them.
We thank you for the invitation. Be glad to sit down, right?
Speak for yourself.
Come with me.
Ladies of the Wood visit you?
If they favor us. My father told me they descended once. Passed from fire to fire, listening to hopes and grievances. So each year, we wait for them to walk amongst us once more.
Haven't done it in a long time, then.
No point waiting to see if we'll get lucky.
Yeah, we gotta try to reach the peak. Mentioned a gate. Said we wouldn't pass.
Only the chosen visit the ladies. Every year, young lads and lasses climb the mount, but never more than three.
Let me guess. The young lads and lasses don't return.
No, they return happy and radiant. But rare is the one who then stays in Velen. Off they go to seek fortune in the wider world.
This celebration, what's it about?
What do you need to know, Wanderer?
No need for anger. The White Ones serve the ladies as we do now. We send them gifts all year long. And on this night, they repay us with their blessing.
I met one of your gifts to the crones. Snivelling.
scared to death, and about 8 years old.
Stay calm. Said the ladies bestow blessings on you.
Aye, for our lives turn thus. First a summer of labor beneath the hot sun, then autumn rains, then a winter of death. Then we await spring, when all that is dead is born anew. And from our blood and sweat, the oak bears acorns. At times few, at times a handful.
What do you do with the acorns?
The Velen elders gather, hold council. Some favor grinding them to spread on the fields for a rich harvest. Others want them given to a cunning woman who'd make medicine for consumption.
A handful of enchanted acorns is enough for all Velen.
Tis never enough.
Your children, why do the ladies need them?
We know not, never ask.
You don't know? Then let me tell you.
Tell us instead what a peasant, his own young and starving, is to do with a wandering war orphan. You're not from here. Don't judge us by others' laws.
Heard enough about this. We've got other questions. We should be going.
Eager to see the ladies. I share your yearning.
We're afire with yearning. Come, Geralt. We must get there before daybreak.
Go to the tent and stand before Thecla. She's the one who decides who's worthy to face the ladies. That's him.
He can never know.
Ow! Greetings!
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
Many errors from thence, the casting off of the veil in the dark.
If only thou gifts are plentiful.
Harm not yourself.
Yeah?
Let me see what you're offering. So long.
Yeah?
Need something crafted. Can you take a look? so long.
For a hard winter.
Oh,
you're
not
going to miss you. Ladies, merciful ladies. Grandson, give him out. He works his share of mischief, but he's a good lad.
Look, a child.
No, a godling. I know him. Name's Johnny.
Well, O.B., you're back. And I see you found your lass. I'm Johnny. We've had the pleasure already. A bit one-sided, though, it was. See, I saw you running. You're back to me. As I was having the pleasure of... Oh, tis a long story.
They call me Ciri. Nice to meet you.
How are things, Johnny?
Health's good, so no complaints. What brings you here?
What are you doing here? Last we met, you and the Crones weren't exactly friends.
I got an invitation I couldn't refuse, same as every year. In their peculiar way, the Crones tolerate my presence and wish to see me at their Sabbath. So I come, wander about, and go home with the rising sun. What about you?
We gotta climb the mountain. Can you help?
I'd rather try to dissuade you, but I'm certain that would be in vain. The lass, she is stubborn as you.
Even more so.
Figured as much. Oh, path to the peak starts there, past the gate. But only old Thekla's got the key, so since you shan't ever get it, you best turn back now.
We're here to find an elf named Imlarith. Ciri thinks he might be a guest of the Crones.
Big bloke, in full plate? Going the right way. He's atop the mountain, all right.
You've seen him?
Saw him in the bog first. Water froze beneath his horse's hooves. Then I saw him again yesterday, heading up this path. Why are you looking for him?
He killed my friend.
Wouldn't seek revenge if I were you. Even the ladies bow and scrape before that one.
The key. Why do you doubt we can get it?
Good grief! You're worse than children. 3 souls are allowed atop the mountain, and only strapping young lads or comely lasses among them. They get the key, open the gate, and meet the ladies.
I believe I qualify.
But he's old and ugly. What good is he?
Pretty damned good at finding lost voices.
Then go find the voice of reason. It'll tell you to turn back. There's no fooling with the ladies.
Gotta get to the summit. Simple as that.
It's Thekla you'll need to convince. She's blind as your bum, but she won't be fooled.
We shan't try to trick her.
She sits in that tent over yonder. I wish you luck, and do hope we meet again, someday. Moons are rising, owls hoot, fire's just a gleam. Hours late and slumber cozy, close your eyes and dream.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
Buried amidst the old troops.
When night begins, bear bellies to the grave.
It's clearing up.
Who's that? Well, come on, come closer, girl. Aye. What's she like?
Narrow hips, sparkly eyes, a striking feisty lass.
Ever had a man? Never mind. Got me answer. I choose you, girl. This night you shall see the ladies.
Ciri.
Wonderful. Who wouldn't want to meet the ladies? My companion comes with me.
What else has the cat dragged in?
It's grey and veiny, got a scar and eyes like a viper.
Aye. Stinks of clotted blood and corpses. Plus it's old and infertile. I reject ye, freak. The girl will ascend alone.
What's this about? What have you chosen her for?
Tell him.
Each year, three chosen have the honor to meet the ladies.
What happens after they've had this honor?
When they return, they speak of the past no more. Joy rules them and they start life anew. The lass were not the first to be chosen this day, but the moon hangs high, so she's like to be the last.
You misjudged me. I'm worthy as anyone.
Girl?
He's spryer than any youth. Only smells like corpses because he kills monsters. And he'll kill any who stand in his way.
Perhaps I was mistaken. Perhaps there's life in him yet. By ancient right, you may appeal my choice. But to do so, you must best the challenge.
What kind of challenge?
Tell him.
You must descend into the cave and bathe in the waters below the earth.
What's the catch?
The water's deep. The water's murky.
I accept the challenge.
Come. Look this over. A coin from days of yore. Falkir burns on its reverse, so they call it the Defier's Auron. Now, bring me the coin. Something's afoot.
Thank you.
was beginning to worry. Come, let's get the key.
Something's afoot. Something's nigh.
They're back. What do you want?
Can't help but be curious. What's at the summit?
Tell him.
The ladies dwell there. But only the Chosen may look upon them.
I know that. I want.
You'll learn nothing else here.
Got that coin you tossed in the lake.
It reeks of sludge.
Nothing I can do about that. So, gonna keep your word?
I always do, my boy. Show the coin to the gatekeeper past the threshold. He'll know its meaning. Marika will open the gate for ye. Now go!
That went smoothly.
Weren't the one to do the diving in that cave.
Stop whining. You're a witcher. You've dived in murkier waters.
Yeah, have to tell you about the time I hunted a Zugul.
The rest of the Chosen will now ascend the mount to the peak to meet the ladies.
Thank you.
What's your name, girl?
What's yours?
Your name don't matter. Atop the peak, you'll lose it and get another. You may go.
And you?
I passed the trial. Here's proof. Recognize it?
The Defiers, Orin. A death sentence.
Bitch.
We've no time to lose. I'll tend to Imlarith, you take the crones. Avalarch said they dwell below the oak, among its roots.
No chance. I'm going after Imlarith.
Fine, let's play for it. Rock, paper, scissors. Damn it! 2 out of 3!
Out of the question. I'll climb the mountain, you face the crones.
Hardly a challenge.
They're extremely dangerous. Be careful.
You too.
We must get down there. Oh, hell. I guess I must jump.
I feel 200 here. How was he? She lived a life of love. And knew no bitterness. Yum, yum. Welcome, child of the Elder Blood. We knew you would return. Your taste lingers on our tongues.
You've talked enough.
Not again! You will die! Here, now!
Imlarith's at the summit. Gotta be. place of power, should draw from it.
Sisters said you would come. They saw you arrive in the water's surface. They did not see the girl, but she is with you, is she not?
I'm here alone.
A lie which will change nothing. Thank you.
To fight like this.
The Witcher you slew.
We did it.
Barely. How'd it go down there?
We slew only two of the crones. The third fled. With Vesemir's medallion. My sole memento.
You avenged Vesemir.
Avalarch claims vengeance is only ever satisfying when served cold. He's wrong. Now to find Eredin and kill him. Anorin, for your thoughts?
Wondering what to tell Yennefer when we get to Novigrad.
Tell her the truth. Always. I wonder if Triss and Yennefer have found the sorceresses at the lodge. We ought to rejoin them.
Yeah, let's get going.
Thank you for coming with me.
Come here.
Let's go.
The oak is dead.
The oak, the crones. I fear that was your last feast.
What of our acorns?
Don't know, don't care.
You must learn to live without them.
This is no longer no man's land. It's no longer the lady's land. It's all yours.
But what are we to do?
Come, Geralt. It's time.
Manage. On your own.
Then non-humans. But it was mages the hunters and the temple guard were after.
Mages left. Hunters needed a new quarry. Hatred and prejudice will never be eradicated, and witch hunts will never be about witches. To have a scapegoat, that's the key. Humans always fear the alien, the odd. Once the mages had left Novigrad, folk turned their anger against the other races. And as they have for ages, branded their neighbors their greatest foes.
Dandelion! Ready some tankards! With guests!
Geralt! Ciri! When I learned Geralt had found you...
Glad to see you in one piece too, Dandelion.
Where have you two been?
Just finished hunting down the Crones of Velen and a general of the Wild Hunt.
Well, you've been a busy morning then, haven't you?
In fact, you look terrible. Like you could really use some rest.
Gladly take some. Point me to a room.
Of course. Come on, little swallow. I'll take you.
Let's meet later, Geralt. A little matter to resolve. I'll freshen up, then await you in the square in Gildorf.
Right. While we were away.
Pretty Polly came down with a fever, and that oyster caught a knife between the ribs, and they're late delivering the sodden triple meat.
Dandelion. Lodge of sorceresses. Triss and Yen were supposed to gather the remnants.
They're working on it. Triss is upstairs, waiting for you. Yennefer's gone to crippled Cates.
Yen? At that portside dive? Why?
Didn't inform me. Imagine that. Ah. And that elf of yours moved into the Ruby Suite. Told me to tell you he's waiting, too.
Gave him your best room?
He didn't exactly ask. I prepared another room for him, but he blew past me and locked himself in the Ruby. Hasn't peeked out since. Barely eats, drinks only water, and the only thing I've heard from him is, I wish to know when Windblade and Zeriel arrive.
Thanks. Looks like I'll have my hands full.
Those sadists ought to change their name now to non-human hunters.
I need a rhyme.